Dear students, welcome and thank you for tuning in to this video. My name is Dr. Lyle Zobie and I am going to explain to you today one example using non-inverting operation amplifier circuit in which we are going to solve a problem, an example to clarify how we are using non-inverting operation amplifier and how to analyze a circuit that has an non-inverting operation amplifier. This is part of a review, the biomedical instrumentation class that I'm teaching. To start with, this is the question that we would like to solve. This is question number two from the series. In the first question, I analyzed an inverting operation amplifier circuit. So in this example, we're going to analyze a non-inverting operation amplifier circuit. So this is the circuit that we want to analyze, and I would like to calculate the current that is passing through our input, this one here, this resistance. And I would like also to find the voltage across our feedback, the feedback resistance here. And also, I would like to calculate the voltage gain for this non-inverting operation amplifier circuit. And I'm going to calculate it in two ways. I will begin by solving for the current. First thing, we would like to calculate the current going through R1. If you recall from the lecture of the operation amplifier, one of the characteristics of the operation amplifier is that the voltage difference between the non-inverting terminal and the inverting terminal should be zero, which means that the voltage here should always equal the voltage there. And if you recall as well from the lecture, no current should be passing from the positive to the negative terminal of the operation amplifier because we have infinite impedance between the two, very high resistance between them. So if I'm taking this into account, it means that very small or negligible current is passing through this resistance here, the 2.7 kilo ohms, which means that the voltage at this point should equal the voltage at this point, which means that the voltage here should equal 2 volt peak to peak. And what I mean by peak to peak, the voltage is not a DC, it's an analog, it's an AC signal, but we will consider that this is a 2 volt potential difference from this point to the ground. And because that is the case here, and no current is passing through, the voltage at this point should equal the voltage at this point, which means that the voltage here should also be 2 volt peak to peak. Now, if you recall from circuits, you have the 2 volt here and you have the ground there. So I can use Ohm's law by saying that the current V, you know, V equals I multiplied by R, and then I can find the current equals the voltage divided by the resistance. And I'm going to name this current to be I input. So I input here, I input should equal the voltage, which is 2 volt peak, it's 2 volt, divided by the resistance, which is 3.3 kilo ohms. And if you do the division here, we are going to end up with 606.1 microampere peaks. It's a microamperes. So if you have this solved, now I know from, also we can recall from the our analysis that the current is not going to pass from the negative to the positive as well from the positive to the negative terminal, which means the entire current here, all of it, is going to be passing through the 18 kilo ohm. None of this current is going to be going through the operation amplifier. Therefore, I can find the voltage across this resistance by saying, you know, by using also Ohm's law. So the voltage equals I input multiplied by the resistance, which is 18. Again, so it's 18 kilo ohms. So that's, if you multiplied 606 microamperes, so that's what's going to happen. 606 micro, which is 10 to the power minus 6, and you multiply it by 18. 10 to the power 3, which is K kilo ohms. This is going to give us a voltage across RF that is equal 10.91 voltage peak to peak. So that's what we're looking for. It's 10.9 volts. And if we would like to, so we were able to identify the current passing through the input resistance, and we also found the voltage across the feedback resistance. Now you can calculate the gain in two different ways. So we'd like to calculate the gain here. So we have two ways. The first we all know that AV, which is the gain, should equals V output over V input. So the first way I would like to get this is using the V output. Now, recall that we need to have a circuit. So you have you have V out. This is your V out from this point to that point. That's our V out. The negative, I can say that if I want to go from this point all the way to that point, from the ground to the ground, this is a closed loop circuit, and I can say that V out equals the voltage across the 18 kilo ohms plus the voltage across the R input, and the voltage across R input is 2 volt. That's what we did before. So I just and I've calculated the voltage across the reference resistance, which is 10.91. So my V output is 2 plus 10.91, and that is going to give us 12.91. That's the two voltages here. That's voltage peak. And if you want to use the AV, which is the gain, I know that the input is 2 volts here. That's my two volt input, and the output is 12. So you can find your gain by saying that the output voltage is 12.91, and you divide it by the input voltage, which is 2, and this is going to give you 6.45. That's your gain. The second way to calculate the gain is actually through using our formula that we learned about in the class. This is a non-inverting pressure amplifier circuit. So if you recall, AV using the feedback resistances, I can calculate the gain. I don't have to calculate the output voltage in order to get and divide it by the input voltage to get the gain. So you can have the AV, which is the gain of a non-inverting pressure amplifier circuit, by dividing the feedback resistance over the input resistance plus 1. That's the formula, and you don't have, there is no negative there. So if you do this, you have 18 kilo ohms, and you divide it by 3.3 kilo ohms, and that is going to, plus 1, don't forget the plus 1. It's very important in non-inverting operation amplifier circuits. So this is going to be, after you do the calculation, 6.45, which is similar to what we got using the V output over V input analysis to get the gain of this circuit. So this circuit is going to multiply the input by 6.45, and that's how we get the output voltage. I hope that clarifies the use and analysis of a non-inverting operation amplifier circuit. Thank you for watching. Until next time. Bye.